So hi, hello and welcome again. Oliver here. Look what I got here. What in the world could that be? Look, it's pretty solid and heavy, made of fully of metal, right? There's a little bit of family history connected to this because I received this as a present when I was a child. Well, 40 years ago and longer. I received this from my grandfather. He gave it to me. I was very fascinated from the very beginning. I even remember that I took it along to elementary school once to demonstrate this. How does it look like? There is, of course, a crank here to turn. Yeah, to turn this crank here. There seem to be some kind of connectors over here, right? And what this is a generator to generate electricity. Yeah, it's also a so-called a magneto or magneto, as they used to call it. And as a matter of fact, this device here is from an old telephone. So if you remember or have seen maybe in old movies, they sometimes used to crank the telephone in order to be connected to another person. And by turning this crank here, a lot of electricity is generated, which was sent down the telephone line. And this electricity caused the ringing of a bell in the other telephone. For actual talking, they used a battery or just electricity from the power socket. But for ringing the bell, you had to turn this, right? And I think I darkly remember that my grandfather somehow told me that this was actually used possibly also in a field telephone in the military, right? So they had to turn that and then they were connected to the next station. Now, it's possible to take it apart carefully because this top part here, that's the magnet. And simply, it's placed on top here. And you can see that in here, when you turn it, there is this, the rotor in there, which contains, maybe you're able to carefully see there are lots of tiny wires, copper wires in here, right? So how many volts is it able to generate? Well, when you spin slowly, around 30 volts, but those generators, if you spin them quickly, were able to make up to 100 volts. And I remember the first time I tried it out, I was holding it here and I was spinning it very quickly and I got a pretty strong electrical shock. Of course, the current passed through my hand. And the body here, that is the ground, so to say, and then this one over here, that provides the power. So what I'm able to do, therefore, is I just want to show to you that it actually does work, and I'm going to connect a multimeter to it, and then later on, look what I got here. It's also possible to make the LED light, but it's possible that I might break it because the voltage and the current are simply too high for this LED. But let's connect the multimeter first. So okay, it's basically generates alternating current. Connected the ground here to the case, and over here the other one here, that's a plus. And I'm going to now spin it, and you can actually see that as you can see, it generates, if I turn it quickly, almost 50 volts maybe. Now I squeezed my finger a little bit in the gear. You get the idea, right? It does work, but the strange thing is, now I bumped my camera. The strange thing is it does not generate any voltage if I rotate the other way. For whatever reason, I dropped this. So for whatever reason, it only works properly in when I rotate this forward. I don't know why. Now let's do the following. Let's connect the LED to this device. Here, that's the tiny LED connected to the case and to the other connector over here. And if I just turn it very lightly, look, that's all it takes. And it lights up very brightly. I think if I spin it too quickly, I'm going to break the LED most certainly, because those LEDs are not able to take a lot of current. But you see, it works quite well. I think it's a very nice piece of old technology. And it's basically now one of those valued objects that I have. And which basically are now kept in a little box together with my other treasures that I have. Hope that you found it interesting. I wish you all the best and hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.